Welcome back to LearnOpenCV. In this video, I will introduce you to PaddlePaddle framework and will also show you how object detection, pose estimation, and segmentation works on PaddlePaddle using a Google Colab notebook. Alright, let's get this started. PaddlePaddle, which stands for Parallel Distributed Deep Learning, is an open source deep learning framework which was developed by Baidu, one of the leading technology companies in China. It was first released in 2016. PaddlePaddle is designed to provide a comprehensive platform for developing, training, and deploying deep learning models. It aims to make deep learning more accessible and efficient by offering a wide range of features and tools that facilitate the entire machine learning workflow. Now, you might be wondering that frameworks such as TensorFlow and PyTorch are already well-known and powerful. Then why PaddlePaddle? It turns out that the benchmark results from the PaddlePaddle paper shows performance boost in different models such as SE ResNet XT50, Mask RCNN, YOLO V3, DeepLab V3, and CycleGAN. There are four main features of PaddlePaddle: data parallelism, model parallelism, TensorRT, and model support. Let's look at each one of them in detail. Data parallelism. It is a technique used in PaddlePaddle that involves splitting the training data across multiple machines. Each machine processes a subset of the data independently. This enables parallel computation and significantly speeds up the training process. Model parallelism. PaddlePaddle uses model parallelism to tackle the challenge of handling larger models with memory constraints efficiently. Instead of relying solely on a single machine, model parallelism allows the division of a single complex deep learning model across multiple machines for parallel computation. TensorRT. TensorRT by NVIDIA helps with the acceleration of inference tasks by optimizing neural network architectures, layer fusion, and leverage GPU-specific optimization. This results in more efficient execution of deep learning models on NVIDIA GPUs. Model support. More than 400 models are available on PaddlePaddle framework from different fields of AI. PaddlePaddle has started integrating its libraries with Hugging Face. As of January 2023, 75 of 400 plus models have been implemented. Alright, let's quickly jump onto a Google Colab notebook and explore Paddle Detection, a repository containing state-of-the-art object detection, tracking, and post-estimation models. So in this notebook, we can see that object detection and key point detection has been explored using PaddlePaddle. In the first initial cell over here, we are just installing PaddlePaddle GPU version 2.4.2. Install setup tools and clone the Paddle Detection repository from GitHub. CD into Paddle Detection. Import all of the necessary libraries required for Paddle Detection to work. Use this download and unzip function to download the detection pose zip that has been given as a asset. Use the pip install command to install the requirements.txt file. Alright, now we can just export the model from Paddle Detection to use it for inference. In this case, we are using a Dino model with a ResNet 50 architecture. The drawbox function allows us to draw high quality bounding boxes on larger images. And in this cell over here, we are just performing inference on a given input image. And we can see that it has detected all of the objects in this image over here. The next cell basically runs object detection inference on a video. So this video inference function over here does that. And we can see that it performs inference frame by frame. In the next section of this notebook, we are trying to do pose estimation on a given input image and video using higher HRNet. So we're just basically trying to export the model over here from PaddlePaddle. Just take a look at the asset shown on screen. Each value in this function is mapped to a body part shown in the illustration. This allows the model to map the movements and estimate the pose efficiently. The same mapping is implemented using this getVariables function in this cell. and then we can just basically plot the key points using circles, and then this function draw polygons can be used to connect the key points to generate polygons. This is the driver code to call all of the functions that we previously saw. And with this cell, we can perform inference on the given input image. So the pose has been estimated in this image over here. Similarly, this can also be done on a video. So we can see that inference has been performed on each frame of the video. Let's quickly hop on to the next notebook and explore Paddle Seg for image segmentation. Paddle Seg supports multiple segmentation tasks such as semantic segmentation, interactive segmentation, panoptic segmentation, and image matting. In this notebook, we'll look into semantic segmentation to classify each possible pixel in an image or a video. Use the pip install command to install Paddle Seg. Now use the git clone command to clone the Paddle Seg repository into your machine. CD into Paddle Seg and install the requirements. These are the necessary libraries required for Paddle Seg to work. Use the download and unzip function over here to download the asset which has been provided in this notebook. In the next cell, we are basically trying to export the model that we are going to use for this segmentation task. So the model has been exported over here. Now that the model has been exported, we can perform inference on a given input image. So we can just call infer.py over here. Alright, so we can see that using this cell over here, we were able to perform inference on a given input image. This method is the CLI implementation to perform segmentation on a given input image. Paddle Seg can also be invoked by writing code. The code over here defines two functions. Get pseudo color map applies the color map to a given mask and saves it as an image. And get color map list generates a pseudo color map for segmentation masks with custom or default colors. This predictor class basically handles all the pre-processing and post-processing tasks required during the segmentation process. We can now use the image inference and the prediction to overlap both the segmentation mask on top of the image. This cell shows the final segmentation image. The driver code shown over here can also be used to perform video inference frame by frame, and this cell performs the inference on video. And that's a wrap for today's video. Make sure to like and subscribe to our channel for more exciting computer vision content. If you have any questions or suggestions, please feel free to leave them in the comments down below. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.